You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Challenge us at Wexford Insurances, 0818 31 30 30.
Welcome back to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with me, Karl Fitzpatrick. I'm now joined in studio by Niall Reck, the owner of Graphedia Web Design based in Wexford Town. Good morning, Niall, and thank you very much for joining me this morning.
Good morning, Karl. It's great to be here.
Niall, you might start by telling me a bit about your own background, please.
Yeah, I'm a local guy originally from Bright Street in Wexford. I attended a vocational college here many, many years ago, which is known as the Tech back then. I then went and went to Carlow IT to study product design. Done my diploma there. And from there, then I was lucky enough to get employment back home in Wexford with a very good IT company. And I spent 3 years there working, doing IT and web design and all those kind of elements.
So, Niall, where did you get the idea to set up Graphedia?
When I was working in the IT company, I was developing websites. It was one of the many jobs I had to do there, but we were developing the websites. It was an area I had great interest in from the design aspect. And it was an area, it was an industry that was starting to grow. So I felt at the time that if I didn't make the move now, I'd never make it. So I attended the Start Your Own Business course with the Wexford County Enterprise Board. And that eliminated the kind of fears of the unknown out there. So 12 months later, Graphedia was born.
And tell me, what does Graphedia do?
Graphedia is a website and graphic design company. We specialize in, on the website side of it, we specialize in website design, development, search engine optimization, Google AdWords, content management systems, and now e-commerce and social media, amongst other graphic design services as well.
So the business is up and running now at this stage, 12 years. Tell me about the first couple of years in business.
First couple of years, I have to say it was all good. We steadily grew year on year. We got some great clients. We still have those clients to this date. It was a challenge, but it was all new and every year has been good.
Now, the web itself has seen phenomenal change take place over the last number of years. What do you see to be the most fundamental of those?
Well, over the last 12 years, there's been many changes. Like 5 years ago, we would have been worrying about resolution, animations, broadband speeds and stuff, but those kind of things have gone. And now we have, with the introduction of mobile and tablet devices, we're now looking at making websites work across a variety of media. So it's not just desktop monitors anymore. You're looking at smartphones, tablets. Along with that, then, we have the growth in the social media side of it, which is from the Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Pinterest, all that, which is making websites more engaging, more interaction with their customer base. So we've had to develop sites to bring all that technology together and make it a greater experience on the web for users.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, Niall. The web is probably the fastest moving market out there today. How do you stay abreast of all those changes?
Yeah, it's basically just being up to date. Like, we attend trade shows, conferencing and stuff like that. We're always reading what's happening in the latest news and stuff like that. But it's really just watching trends, seeing what's happening out there, you know, looking at new technology, looking at what devices are coming out. So you're always you're watching an array of things. You're listening to what others are saying, but you're also watching what's happening in the market.
Yeah, that causes its own challenges for any business to be able to, I suppose, focus on today and the business as it is. But not only that, but for you to keep an eye on the future markets as well in terms of the way they're going, and to make sure that you can keep your skill set up to date.
Absolutely, Carl. There's a continuous need for us to be updating our own skills in-house and stuff. So we invest an awful lot in training and updating the software to keep up to date with all the latest tech, I suppose.
In your opinion, Niall, have business people here in Ireland embraced the web as a real way of generating business?
Definitely they have, yeah. Over the years, they've always been progressive in getting their businesses online. But recently, in the last 2 years, they've really become more aggressive in getting online and investing in their websites with staff and technologies, and making it a better user experience for their customers and for people just to know all about their business. So yeah, definitely.
We've all heard the stories about people that have invested in websites, but those websites have never generated any sales for them. So they've never generated any calls. They've never generated any email contact. The websites themselves are hard to find. What are the reasons for that?
Yeah, it's down to, there's a number of factors there. One, content is always king. And you want to make the content easier for people to read without boring them into your life story. You want to make it easy for people to contact you from the site. So you want your phone number and email address easily accessible, but also make it interesting. the other side of it is getting found on Google is key to any website. And that's, there's a technique to that, and it's not just you have a website, Google's going to find you. You have to invest in the search engine optimization and the search engine marketing of your business. So you're talking about learning and putting in the right metadata to get you found on Google. You may think what your product is on Google, but your customers could be typing in something totally different. So you need to understand what your customers are typing into Google to find a product or a service that you provide.
So, Niall, from your experience, do Google change the rules regularly?
They do. And it's to help a better search experience for people on Google. So, but what I would say there is, if you have the basics done right, with regards to your metadata and the content of your site and how it's performing and how it's designed and stuff like that, you'll always do well on Google. So then when they do make changes, it's an easier implementation rather than having to start again. So like we would have seen that Google made the big change 3 months ago with its latest algorithm change. So now they're, what they have is you still have all your metadata and content, but they want to see you being more active on your website. So they want to see you blogging. They want to see you interacting with Facebook and Twitter and YouTube and integrating all that into your site. And again, making it a better user experience with your customers.
So Niall, I suppose in simple terms, there's two types of website out there today. Firstly, you have your brochure style website, and secondly, you have the e-commerce type site. Let's focus on the brochure type site first. What needs to be right for it to rank well on Google?
For it to rank well on Google, again, you need content. You need a well-performing website, a well-designed website that will work well for Google and not work against Google, I suppose. But content is king. Have it well-optimized for Google. You know, have the right metadata in it again. You know, get your keywords down right and stuff like that. To make it work for a customer point of view, have a clear call to action on it. So do you want them to make a call? Do you want them to make a booking? Have all that very much in their face. And integrate your whole social newsletter, all those features into your site now. You know, bring it all together and have it in one place.
Okay, Niall. And I suppose, look, as over the last number of years, you know, as more and more Irish consumers buy online, the e-commerce type site is growing at a phenomenal pace. What are the fundamentals to getting that right?
Yeah, great point. An awful lot more people are shopping online and converting to e-commerce websites. But we have a few tips here to help you create a better user experience for your customers. So again, treat your e-commerce stores like your shopfront. You want a clean and uncluttered design. Make it feel safe and welcome. So, you know, you don't want it to look like a template or something cheap anyway. Make it nice and be proud of it. Make it clear and easy to get around. Offer assistance if you can, you know, with little web forms and stuff. And make it a good shopping experience and make it a unique style to your brand. And that's from a user experience perspective. And then to help sales come in through your e-commerce website, good SEO. Optimize it a must again. Optimize every product, optimize every category, optimize your website. Follow that with maybe an effective Google AdWords campaign. It's a must now. And get up to speed on QR codes. And again, entice users to buy online with discount codes and coupons, etc. So entice them onto your shop. And make them register online.
Niall, over the course of the last 10 minutes, you've mentioned keywords a few times and metadata. How would a business owner listening to the show today carry out research to identify the right keywords that they should have on their site itself?
Yeah, good question. It's down to keywords or key phrasing, I suppose you would call it. So basically what you can use either the Google keyword search tool. You can do a competitor analysis, see what your competitors are using. That's easily found out by looking at their source code. And again, the most practical one out there is when you're talking to your clients, ask them. Ask them what they would type into Google to search for a certain product. You'd be surprised what your clients type in and what you presume they type in. So asking your clients is always a good one as well. But any of those three there would be a very good start.
In respect of social media, do you think it's overrated for business?
No, social media is a must for businesses now, and they really need to integrate, and they are integrating it more, I suppose, with their businesses. So it just keeps their customers informed of changes, new products, new special offers. It's really making people very aware of brands that are out there that they probably didn't know about before. So a very good social media campaign can make brands really stand out. So, and we've seen that happen. That's a definite, yeah.
Niall, sites developed on WordPress seem to be ranking better than any other site out there on Google. What's the reason for that?
Yeah, definitely. WordPress is basically just doing something that we were doing manually for years. So where before you had to create very content aware and metadata HTML pages, WordPress has taken out all the kind of coding part of it that we would have had to do manually and doing it automatically. So it's really creating very HTML content-rich pages with less code. So Google really, you know, it loves all that kind of stuff. But again, there's other CMSs as well that do the same job, but WordPress is becoming the most popular. So you have your Joomlas, your Drupal, but WordPress, we would use WordPress all the time now ourselves. So it is, it's key from a Google point of view and from a user updating their own website point of view. It makes it a lot easier for people to be able to maintain their own websites as well. So, and they're very expandable as well. So where before you would have had to handwrite or hand code certain things for certain clients, now it's a lot easier to add plugins to WordPress. So, you know, you're not stuck with the same thing. It's very easy to expand. But yeah, and that's why Google likes it as well.
Niall, over the last couple of years, I know that the government have taken a very proactive approach to shifting businesses online. I suppose the fact that they see, look, how easy it is to trade internationally and that. What have they been doing locally to support that initiative?
Yeah, like we've seen that ourselves. Like we've e-commerce stores there for years now, and we do see people sending out orders across Austria, Spain, France, UK, and all over Ireland and stuff like that. And this is why they're encouraging us. So the enterprise boards and the local authorities and stuff are giving grants for website development. So your local county enterprise board have e-business grants. Now they're out at the moment, but in January they'll be back. So you can get 50% towards the cost of developing a site. And if you're a rural-based company, you can always talk to your local development association. So we have the Wexford Local Development, or WLD, here. And they can help you funding on developing a whole e-commerce website experience and, you know, develop a marketing thing around that as well. So, yeah, they're very proactive, and it's a great thing to see.
Well, Niall, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for coming in this morning and wish you continued success with Graphedia Web Design.
You're listening to Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick in association with Wexford Insurances. Think Wexford Insurances for your business insurance.